you bring my heart a strange delight when you sigh and sigh. Ocean breeze, your chilly fingers touch my face, but I can feel a warmth.
There isn't enough for both of us.
My sentiments exactly. Now, what about the wallet, honey?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You just gave the bellboy a $2 bill that was part of a short snorter that I carried all through the war.
Get out of my room.
Look, honey, I've had a hard day. Now just give me the wallet and we'll forget the whole thing.
I've already forgotten it. Shove.
Senora. Senor Cochran. You saved me the need for a visit. It has become necessary to enforce our laws against vagrancy. Since you are without funds, you will leave Macao at the first opportunity. My regrets, senor.
What's that got to do with your barging in here?
You will let me explain, senora. I am not here to see you in my official capacity.
I ought to make you apologize. Haven't you lost a little weight since I saw you last?
Now will you get out of here?
In a moment, senora, but first, please allow me to be of some small service to you.
I've heard that one before.
Oh, you misunderstand.
Okay, what is it?
I was at the dock when I heard you say that you are a singer. Felizardo, I said to myself, here is a beautiful young lady to grace the dull existence of Macao. So being a man with a practical side to my nature, I hurried to Senor Vincent Halloran, owner of the largest gambling establishment on the island. Vincent, I said, our friendship is at an end unless you give this young lady a chance.
Does that mean you've got a job for me?
Precisely.
Well, why didn't you say so?
Your pardon, senora. How soon can you be at his office?
As soon as you get out of here, I can get dressed.
Goodbye, Miss Benton. It is indeed a pleasure to welcome a young lady graced with such beauty of face.
Yeah, officer, me too.